Alrighty, so this is going to be somewhat of a new series. I wanted to start it last year, but I never got around to doing it. So I'm going to start it now, and I'm going to start it with my home park. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tear this park apart and go over what I really hate about the park and what I really would like to see them do with certain areas of the park. I'm going to do this for every park that I visited, but of course, Canada's Wonderland is first. And obviously, on the screen to start, we have Time Warp. So I think everyone agrees that Time Warp is one of those coasters. It's not a terrible coaster. A lot of Americans that come over and ride it really love it, but it does not belong at a park like Canada's Wonderland. Canada's Wonderland is one of the most attended seasonal theme parks in North America. And it's just a very kind of like low capacity slash small scale coaster that's designed for almost like a boardwalk or a park like Michigan's Adventure. Nothing like Canada's Wonderland. So definitely would like to see that get replaced. What I would like to see it get replaced with kind of comes into play with this next coaster that I'm going to go over. So we have Flight Deck. Flight Deck is sitting right next door, and it is also a coaster that no longer belongs at Canada's Wonderland. Now, it is a very tossed up coaster in terms of opinions. You have some people that love it, and the people that love it usually don't understand what else could replace it. So the general public who love it don't understand that there are inverts out there that will not hurt you and will not try and kill you during the ride cycle, and that is why they may not hate it. So what would I like to see replace these two coasters? Well, obviously either a B&M Flyer or a B&M Wing coaster would fit this place really well. An invert could also fit really well, and I would send Time Warp over to Michigan's Adventure or another small scale park to help relieve that. Marketplace. So looking outside inwards, it looks beautiful. So Marketplace is one of my favorite places to eat right now. The food is kind of mediocre, kind of upscale. It depends on the day you go. Sometimes they have really great food. Sometimes they have really bad food. The food does change daily, which is weird. And I really like the theming on the outside. I love the sign. Everything about it is amazing. But the minute you step foot inside this building, it is falling apart. It is not something that should be presented to the Canada's Wonderland audience. It doesn't match the area's theming. It's like the flooring is falling apart. It's literally like painted concrete and the paint is chipping. The furniture is just falling apart. The signage inside, the artwork is great and everything. It's just the flooring and the food that I wish they would improve. And then actually alongside it is the old beer garden that they no longer use and I wish they would bring back. It is a perfect area for a bar. I'm talking a fully licensed bar serving any alcoholic beverage that you would like to purchase. I would love to see something like that in the rear end of this building. I think that would be phenomenal. I would love to go order a strawberry daiquiri or even a martini or just even like a rum and coke or just something different from beer and soda-like beverages from inside the park. Now that brings me over to Riptide. Riptide, you may be asking, what do I have against this ride? It is a great ride. We used it in a lot of our ride challenges for the 2019 season, but there's something about it that just doesn't belong. So Riptide is a ride that I think doesn't need to be removed. A lot of people think it's going to be removed shortly because it does have, I should say it has had a lot of downtime. I'm going to say this ride has had next to no downtime this season, and I'm there quite often. I'm there almost all the time. I'm already at almost 100 visits for the season, and this ride is up and running almost all the time, but it just doesn't fit in theming-wise. Right behind it, you have Dragonfire, then you have Spinnovator, you have the themed kind of castle right next to it, and then you have Riptide with racing stripes painted onto it and this sort of like mechanical theme. I don't really know what it is. It just doesn't belong. I would love to see it rethemed because I don't think it needs to go. There's no need to remove it. It would look really awkward in this area without a flat ride. And if you're going to remove it, maybe put something in like a Screamin' Swing and theme it to the medieval area. I would love to see them completely retheme Medfair. And not necessarily retheme, that's a poor word choice, but kind of like upgrade its theming so everything belongs, which is going to be the theme of this video for the next probably 2 minutes. So then we have Drop Tower. Drop Tower is another ride that doesn't need to go. It's amazing. Craig loves it. I love it. It's great. I actually like it better than I liked the taller drop rides at Great Adventure. But it doesn't belong. It's themed to who knows what, a racetrack, I guess. You're racing down the tower is its theme, thus the racing stripes, and right beside it is Speedway. But it just doesn't fit in. These two attractions, Speed City Raceway and Drop Tower, need to be rethemed. Drop Tower I could see being painted like it was over at California's Great America. I would love to see them paint some sort of like castle tower look to it, like the brick stonework going up, and then maybe even add like decal at the top to make it look like the tower tops, you know, with that uneven look, I guess, and have it themed to like storming the castle tower. I don't know, like you're going up and storming and then something goes wrong, something stupid like that. Anything. Speed City Raceway sits in the way of a RMC renovation of Wild Beast, but I don't think that's happening anytime soon. So at the current moment, I just don't see how this fits into the storyline of Medfare. Maybe they could partner up with a PlayStation game that gives it a medieval fair theme, like maybe paint the carts to wagons. I don't know. If you're going to keep it, fix it up or hide it a little better so it's kind of like on the outskirts. I hate the gas smell when I'm in line for Leviathan. I actually find it unbearable now. Breathing in the fumes from the go-karts, it's that bad. On a really hot summer day, I can hardly breathe in the line of Leviathan. Even in the fast lane line, it's gotten really bad. I don't like it. I think these need to go. They should have been built over an action zone, but I know Paramount, blah, blah, blah. Wild Beast. So this is an attraction that I would love to see get RMC'd or removed for a better attraction. And that could be any attraction, maybe even a mock double launch, anything pretty much at this point to replace it. I think the wooden coasters at Canada's Wonderland don't really fit into the lineup anymore. It's an upscale park. It's starting to define itself on the world stage. And those are attractions that I would like to see be upgraded or removed. Shockwave. So this is another attraction that just doesn't make sense in Medfare. It's right at the exit. I would love to see them to define the exit of Medfare over here. Maybe even have more castle gates as you're exiting. Right near Shockwave. Shockwave can stay in, theme it to some sort of torture device or something. Just repaint it. I have no idea. Maybe even theme it to like some sort of battling ram or some sort of contraption that's designed to destroy a castle wall. Have the castle walls right next to it as you're exiting Medfare. Just something unique like that would help greatly. Again, these are very expensive ideas added up in total. It doesn't need to do take place over a year, but I would love to see these things happening over time. The Fly. So this is one of those things I've talked to a lot of people. It sits in Frontier Canada now, and it just doesn't make sense. And a lot of people actually discuss, does it sit inside Frontier Canada or does it sit inside the mountain area? Regardless of where it sits, it doesn't fit its Alpine theme and it doesn't fit its Frontier Canada theme. So something needs to be done. I just don't like it. It kind of like has this lost identity now where it's kind of like in between two worlds and the worlds haven't even fought over the identity of the Fly. I've heard a lot of people saying like make it an indoor attraction. That would help with even Winterfest, having it open during Winterfest. You have a family coaster open during Winterfest. And theme it to Northern Lights was an idea I heard that I really like. You know, have it like you're inside the building and there's like almost like Northern Lights and the Arctic, maybe theme it to something like that. You could even have like a lumberjack theme as if you're like inside a log that's gone crazy down a river. You could go down so many routes that are cheesy Canadian themes, or if it's in the Alpine area, if you're going to put it in the mountain, redefining the mountain's Alpine old classic theme with this coaster would be awesome. If you don't want to put it indoors, that makes sense as well, because that would be extremely pricey. And it would also be an eyesore. So again, with the indoor theme and the indoor building, it would be a complete eyesore to the area. So I would like to see more of an Alpine theme or maybe even the lumberjack log theme that I was discussing. The food buildings at Canada's Wonderland. Ugh, don't even get me started. I hate it. This park does not know how to do food. It frustrates me beyond belief. The only thing good that this park does is have the fast lane lines for people with meal plans. That's the only thing that they do right. In fact, I love that. But having one to two cash registers open on an extremely busy day, this is a bad example because this isn't a busy day, but there are sometimes hour-long lines just to order your food. And then you have like a 30-minute wait to pick up your food. It's atrocious and they need to fix it. That is like number one on the list of things they need to fix. I cannot stand it. I know the average guest can't stand. That park needs to do so much with food, and we'll get into a little bit more of that further on in the video. Whitewater Canyon. So you're probably like, why is Whitewater Canyon in this video? It's great. It is a great attraction. Not much needs to be done, but I know that something's coming down the road. I guess we'll see an upgrade or maybe even some sort of Forbidden Frontier attraction take over the Whitewater Canyon area. It could go one of those couple of routes. Action Theater's old plot of land is definitely sitting there wasted by not being used. They're currently using it for Winterfest storage and some sort of musical festivals in the school year. But it also has an empty plot of land that could be used for a flat ride to fit into the Frontier Canada area. Even the building could be turned into some sort of 4D kind of theater attraction that showcases Canada, like Flying Over Canada, something similar to that. I would like to see that building turned into. There's just so much potential in this area, and I would like to see them utilize that to the fullest. It's just so much potential back here. Again, I definitely see a Forbidden Frontier type attraction coming back into the Whitewater Canyon area, and then Action Theater being changed into some sort of attraction other than storage and an employee break room. There's just so much potential back there, and hopefully Wonderland utilizes it. Again, this is an area of the park that still is a complete forest, and there's just so much they can do back here. And again, we're hearing that Forbidden Frontier is most likely coming to Canada's Wonderland, and I'm expecting that 2021 may be the year for the Forbidden Frontier attraction. And the only place that really makes sense is either Dinosaurs Alive or the Whitewater Canyon Forest area. There's just so much potential back here. And they may not even have to remove Whitewater Canyon. They can probably fit that into the storyline somehow without removing the attraction. And then redesigning the queue line and exit area and removing Corn Stalkers. From what I've heard, Corn Stalkers has been on the rumor mill to be removed or moved. So this is all adding up to a Forbidden Frontier attraction for 2021. Now that we know that Canada's Wonderland is most certainly not in the running for a 2021 coaster. So it makes sense that Forbidden Frontier would probably be the 2021 addition to Canada's Wonderland, and 2022-2023 is most likely going to be the coaster year for Canada's Wonderland, because we know that King's Dominion and Cedar Point are going to get coasters in 2021, and those are two bigger parks, and those are going to be two big coasters, and I know that eats up the budget, and there is no room for another big park to get a coaster, so it's either going to be just those two, or those two and a small park getting a small coaster. Behemoth. Why is Behemoth in here? Well, it needs to be repainted. This coaster is definitely fading, and I was expecting a repaint for its 10th anniversary, but that didn't happen. So maybe its 11th or 12th anniversary, we can see a repaint. I would love to see them kind of like actually give this coaster an identity. A lot of people are like, well, it has an identity. It's Behemoth. I would love to see a color scheme match that identity. I'm not liking the Cedar Fair color scheme that they gave Behemoth when they first built it. Again, that was under a different CEO, a CEO that I completely hate and I find to be one of the dumbest CEOs I've ever heard of for the Cedar Fair chain or Six Flags chain. He was a horrible person selling off land that they shouldn't have sold off. But I would love to see them give it kind of like a brown or some sort of monster paint scheme that matches the Behemoth name. And maybe a new sign. I know a lot of people disagree with me. I just don't like the big letters Behemoth. I would have liked to see it in stone up front if they were going to go down that route. But the water park is another area that needs investments. So the water park is extremely small for the capacity that this park sees on the daily basis. Again, this is a bad example. This was a cold day that we filmed this video. We actually filmed it last week. And it just needs more water slides. They need more water slides. They need a better kids play area. Like those play structures that a lot of the water parks around have way better now. Wet n Wild is an extremely better water park just down the road from Wonderland. So in my opinion, there is just no point to go to Wonderland's water park. Grab a season pass to Wet n Wild and avoid Wonderland's water park. I just think it's completely a nightmare to find a spot in there, to have clean access to showers because there's just too many people, and to wait literally like an hour to get on one water slide. It's just not worth it. Go to Wet n Wild. We went on a busier day and it was still very manageable. So I can only imagine non-busy days. Definitely one of those water parks you have to go check out, and avoid Canada's Wonderland's water park until maybe next year with the cliff jumping, and then hopefully maybe future years more to do. Mess Hall. Mess Hall is a miss. I hated the food here. It sucked. It looks like all the guests hate the food here. This place never has a line, even on busy days. So I think they completely failed with the food choice for this building. And I have to be honest, I'm not liking the chef for Canada's Wonderland anymore. The food is a joke this season. I want to see it upgraded. Action Zone is another part of the park that I would love to see upgraded. I find it to be the ugliest part of the park. It looks like your average non-themed theme park or amusement park in this area. This building right here is my least favorite building in the entire theme park, the arcade. I just want to see it be taken back over by the international fair that they used to have. I want to see the Asian building come back to Backlot Cafe. It had a really awesome Asian theme. And I just want to see all those like Mayan themes come back and Action Zone be slowly bulldozed. Kingswood. Kingswood is a part of the park that sits there in waste. It needs to be utilized. I think they need to be holding more concerts if they're going to keep the tent area. I think they need to be holding events. They could be selling tickets and getting people into the park to spend money by having more concerts and stuff in this venue. They have a big washroom in the back. They now have like the venue building that they just built last year, and they have the massive tent that can hold like, I think I heard a crazy number of like 15,000 people that tent can hold. So they should be holding events there for sure. Again, this is that new building they built. It's just a perfect area for them to be holding events, and it's big enough that they can literally house the people out there and have them kind of have range into the park. They have a ticket booth and everything. I would build an outside ticket booth as well. Utilize this event in the winter even. Like, have like those concerts in the fall, like on weekdays. You know, have music artists come on Fridays and perform at Friday night when the park's not open on a Friday. There's ways to make money with this venue, and they just don't seem to be utilizing that. I would love to see them utilize that in the future, especially since they're investing money into the area. Again, this would be another area that I would love to see them maybe even add a full functioning bar to if they're going to start utilizing it for events. Just something unique, and again, some more way to build profit outside of the actual dry and wet park. We do have a hotel coming, so I would love to see the hotel paired with more events at the venue. I think it would be extremely beneficial. Again, we come back to the Action Zone, and you have this extremely ugly area that Paramount literally plastered over top of beautiful theming and ruined the whole Taft era of Canada's Wonderland. And I would love to see Cedar Fair fix that. Again, most of the problems that I'm pointing out about Canada's Wonderland are not Cedar Fair's fault. Not sitting here crapping on Cedar Fair, because Cedar Fair is literally cleaning up what Paramount did to Canada's Wonderland. And you can tell that they do care about the park, and they are definitely fixing a lot. So this is just something that I'm hoping that Cedar Fair kind of like fixes over time. Backlot Cafe is one of the ugliest buildings in the park, especially on the inside. It takes extremely long to get your food, and you're sometimes not even allowed to sit in that venue building back there. And half of the building is never in use. You're not allowed on the right side of the building. It's for events. Even when they're not holding events, you're not allowed over there, and it doesn't make sense. And they remove the pop machines, which is super annoying. So we always have to go walk a distance, grab a pop, then go grab our food in there, and then sit down. It's just so inconvenient. Wonderland needs to fix that again. When it comes to food, Wonderland does not know what they're doing. I'm sorry to say, I love Wonderland, but they have no idea how to run food and restaurants. They need all new people in that park for the food and beverage, or Cedar Fair needs to invest more. I have no idea what's going on. I'm not going to point my finger because I don't know. It's just not working, and they need to fix it. Every other park is getting beautiful restaurants, and Wonderland is serving chicken fingers and fries still. I have no idea. They need to fix it. They don't have an identity of what they're trying to serve. Again, Mess Hall was an example of that. Just a complete fail, and I would love to see that fixed. Anyways, hope you enjoyed this video of what I think Wonderland needs to fix in the coming years. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't, and share this video for others to enjoy. And don't forget to comment down below what you think you would like to see come to Wonderland in the coming years. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a good one. Bye.